into physics class. In continuation to the previous class, that is the first question. So, in the question it is given that there are n number of resistors connected in series. There are n number of resistors connected in series. So, n resistors are there. These are all connected in series, equal resistors, R, 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 that is n equal resistors are connected in series. So they are in series, so equivalent resistance in series is equal to, series combination is equal to R plus R plus R plus and so on n times we have to add R. So we get n into R is the equivalent resistance in series. Rs means the equivalent resistance connected in series. Now, the same resistors now are connected in parallel. The n resistors are connected in parallel. Okay, they are connected in parallel. So, what is the equivalent resistance in this case? What is the equivalent resistance in this case is asking. N times it is connected. So, same resistors we are taking R, R, R. So, equivalent resistance in parallel connection be Rp. So, 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by R plus, 1 by R plus, and 1 by R plus, and so on up to n times. N times we have to add. So, we get 1 by Rp is equal to n by R. N into R. All denominators are the same. We can add the numerators 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus n times. So, n into 1 is n. N by R. But I want R parallel, that is equal to R by N. Okay. So we got the equivalent resistance in parallel connection. We got the equivalent resistance in series connection. Now he is asking the ratio of maximum to minimum. What is the ratio of maximum to minimum? So he is asking Rs by Rp. So that is equal to N into R by N. So R and R get cancelled, the N get reciprocal, so that is equal to N square is our answer. Okay, like this we have to do. Next question, 71st question, 72nd question, okay, 72 question. So what he is asking in the 72 question is, the resistance in series, means resistance are connected in series. We know that when the resistors are connected in series, that is n resistors are connected in series, equal n resistors are connected in series, we know it is nr. So resistances, equal resistances connected in series, we get it is nr. Okay, when equal resistors are connected in series, we get NR, and internal resistance of the cell is R. He is saying that the internal resistance of the cell is given. Internal resistance of the cell, that is equal to R. So, internal resistance of the cell is given. So, what will be the total resistance in resistors connected in series? N number of resistors connected in series. N number of equal resistances connected in series. NR. Internal resistance of the cell is also R only. So we get a total resistance. We are going to add the total resistance. Means we are going to add this resistance plus this resistance. So we get NR plus R. This is equal to n plus 1 into R. I have taken R common in both the terms. So, n plus 1 into R. This is the total resistance. So, now he is asking to calculate current. So, how to find the current value? We know the resistance, total resistance we know, R total we know, and the current is equal to voltage by total resistance, V by R. Okay. So, current is equal to V by R. So here we got a current, and in the same manner, these resistors are connected in parallel also. Now the resistances are connected in parallel. N number of equal resistances are connected in parallel now. Then what happen? You will get R by N. Just before problem we have done. When N resistances, equal resistances are connected in parallel, we get R by N. Internal resistance is R. So in this case, what is the total resistance? RT. This is you take as RT1. This you take as RT2. Total resistance connected in parallel. This is R by N plus R. So you take R common means what you will get? 1 by N plus 1. 1 by N plus 1. So this is the total resistance, equivalent resistance when the resistors are connected in parallel. And the internal resistance will be always series with the parallel resistance and series with the series resistances. No change in that. So that's why we are adding plus R, plus R. So this is the thing we got. Now in this case, what is the current he said? The current is 10i. 10 times the current is increased. 10i now. 10i must be equal to how much? The total voltage, that is V, by a total resistance, that is V into 1 by N plus 1. Okay. So both represent the currents only. This is one current, that is I is equal to when series connection, and current increased when parallel connection. Parallel connection, the current is increased, so voltage remain constant in both the terms, right? So total voltage is same both the connections. So now what we do is we have to take the ratio of these two things. So I am dividing, this is equation number 2, this is equation number 1. So I am dividing 2 by 1. Equation 2 by 1 means 10i by I is equal to 10i. How much we got? V by R into 1 by N plus 1 divided by V by R into N plus 1. This one we got. Okay. So now what we do? V, R, R cancel, V, V cancel. So this gets reciprocated. So here I cancel. So that is nothing but 10 is equal to N plus 1 by, to take LCM, here you will get 1 plus N by N. So nothing but N plus 1 by N you will get. Okay, so both are same here. N and N get cancelled. N plus 1 and N plus 1 will be getting cancelled. So here you will get the number of resistors, that is N you will get. This N gets reciprocated. So N is equal to 10 you will get. N is equal to 10. Okay, so 10 resistors are connected in this case. Okay. So what he is asking in the 73rd question, find internal resistance, he is asking. Internal resistance R is equal to how much, he is asking. Okay. So what are the things he has given? I is equal to given. Current is given. Current is given as 0.2 amps. And E is given as 2.1 volts. And R is given as 10 ohms. So these are the things he has given. He is asking internal resistance. So whenever internal resistance he is asking, the relationship between first of all the voltage and internal resistance means EMF is always equal to voltage of the circuit plus the voltage drop at the internal resistance of the battery. This is our EMF formula. EMF is always greater than voltage. Okay. So voltage means the potential difference across the end points of the circuit, that will be voltage. EMF means potential difference strictly across the terminals of the battery when the circuit is open. When the circuit is open, we have to find EMF. When the circuit is closed, we have to find the voltage, that is potential difference. So always EMF should be greater than voltage. And here V is equal to, we know that IR, V is equal to IR. So you substitute in this, E is equal to IR plus I small r. So I you take common, what you will get? I of R plus R. Now I want current only, right? So we want internal resistance, right? So R plus R is equal to E by I. I want R, small r. So E by I minus capital R. I send this R to this side, it becomes minus. Okay? So now we got everything, you know, E, you know, I, you know, R, you know, all you substitute in this. What you will get? 2.1 by 0.2 minus 10. So here point and decimal point get cancelled. So 2 1s are 210.5. So that is equal to 0.5 ohms. This is a small r. This is a small r. Like this. Okay, the internal resistance must be equal to 0.5 ohms. Like this, we can calculate the internal resistance of a given battery or cell. Now 74th question. So in this question he is also asking here to find out the graph. He is asking the graph, which graph is suitable here, he is asking. So in this graph, if you see, the graph is drawn between